Hi guys, this is Dharam Singh, and today I'm with Vincenzo. He's my friend, he was my student, and he's a very learned person coming from Italy, Rome, and he's working for a corporate, and he's in teaching, training, mentoring. He's a great guy, so I'm very, very happy to have him on this program. Vincenzo, welcome here.
Thank you, Dharam. It's a pleasure to be with you here today to promote the PhD in PE certification in Italy and Europe.
Perfect. So we are promoting PGMP in Europe, but in general we are talking various topics so that yes, how we try to figure out how PGMP is helping professionals to grow into the corporate world. Okay. So Vincenzo, I have a very interesting question. What do you feel the program management or PGMP is giving you a differentiator? How it has given you extra wings to grow in the organization? What has changed from before PGMP and after PGMP?
So Dharam, thanks for the question because I can tell you my real story. I was always dreaming to get the PGMP certification, as a personal objective, but I was always too busy with my job, etc., etc. But that was a kind of dream in the box. Now, almost a year ago, you should be aware that I was part of a very big contract with my company, and regretfully, we lost the contract, okay? And I was impacted by this. Now, you should know that I've been always a very strong performer, respected by my manager, respected by my teammate, respected even by the customer. But when you lose a contract, you lose a contract. There is no grace for you, okay? And modern companies are not helping you at all. My boss was in North America and he said to me, Vincenzo, you need to find your way, okay? And in modern companies, finding your ways means that you need to search for the internal job market and start applying for positions, okay? Because nobody is really helping you or really takes care of you. If you don't take care by yourself, you are all alone. Okay. Now, while just before this happened, okay, in reality, I was trying to make my dreams reality in the PGMP world, okay? And one of my starting point was that, I have a lot of friends. I'm part of many project manager communities, and I saw that a lot of people were getting the PMP certification in my company and in my country. And I was thinking, maybe I need to differentiate myself. Maybe I need to elevate myself in a way. And so, that's when I getting connected with you, okay? And I decided to really value my professional profiles. You helped me understand if I was fit for the certification because not everybody can do that. And when you said to me, no, Vincenzo, you have enough competency, history, etc., so you can be successful. I decided to really, make my own money and time investment, okay, in agreement even with my family to say, let's make an investment because this will pay out in a way or another, okay? When I did this, I was safe, I had no risk, everything was fine. Now, the interesting part of this story happens when I really got this drawback, in my career. I had to find opportunities. And so I start making application and also leveraging my personal network with some of the executive I knew in my company to ask for jobs. Okay. Now, the first thing that I noticed is that when I was talking blah, blah, blah about all the great things that I did, nobody was giving a lot of attention. Okay. Probably because everybody, when you talk about yourself, everybody's a great guy. You did a lot of work. You are fantastic, etc., etc. But when I was mentioning that not only I was PMP, and I'm also certified in Six Sigma, but I also recently got the program manager certification, I said, really? I said, yes, of course. Okay. And it's a kind of strange sensation because people say, haha, You see, let's see if this, what this brings to me. Now, after some research that lasted almost 6 months, I was able to find a new role in my organization. Okay. And when I settled, you know, when I start becoming part of the organization, I decided to ask why I was selected. Okay. So I said, why you have chosen me? Okay. Why me and not somebody else? Okay. And the people I talk to, say, of course, Vincenzo, you know, when I talk to you, it's clear that you have a lot of experience. It's clear that you know how to manage large teams and large organizations, that you have a clear understanding of how to drive multiple teams and multiple programs in a successful way. But the fact that you also got the certification, which is very difficult because we really know that PGMP certification is an important and difficult achievement, proved that in reality, first of all, you have a professionalism that our company can use inside but also outside with customers. And they also said something else, because they said to me, this also proves that your brain is still awake, you know, because you had to study, you have learned the new words, you have learned the new ideas. And for us, we need these people in our company. We don't need people that are seated on what they learned 10 years ago. We want people that are continuously learning. And they also said, and we are also looking forward that you are bringing new ideas in the company.
Yep.
So whatever you are learned in the program management standard from PMI, but also things that you are taking from other environments, please bring this new idea to us. Because our organization needs to get, quote unquote, new ideas and new brain power, and this can be come just from the outside. Okay? And I also noticed something else, because when I then start working with external customer, because they then, I was, start presenting me to some external customers, okay? When again I was mentioning the PGMP certification and I was underlining that I was in Italy 1 out of 17 people, people said, ha, okay, and that, you know, this kind of strange recognition, okay, was helping me set the stage. Okay, of course you have to deliver. A good, you know, business card is good to start a relationship, but afterwards you have to deliver. So, this is my story, and I can tell you that personally speaking, for me has been really an important investment, and the payout is enormous. So all of the things that I learned from PMI, but also in the coaching and mentoring session with you, were really of enormous value, and my words, my way of thinking has evolved dramatically, not because I was not doing that, but the words, the view that I'm now bringing is really from a completely different perspective. So this is my story, Dara.
Great, great. Very, very interesting story. And yes, when, you know, I know when you are, you and a couple of other people in the class, you know, when we started the program versus when we finish, it was, you know, very, very big change in you and everybody. Because you learn and apply the knowledge into your day-to-day life. And that is the most important thing. Certification is good to have, but what do you do with the certificate is more important. So I'm glad that it has helped you. And so as most people know now that PMPs are now, it's a more than million PMP. So almost every second person is PMP, whether they are project manager, program manager, portfolio manager, or a director level, they are PMP. And PGMP is still around 3,000 and a very, very low number if you compare to PMP. So like in Italy, so you mentioned 1 out of 17 and as PGMP, probably 1 out of 5,000 PMP. And that's one out of 5,000 is not giving you the value you're looking for. So, yes, PMP is kind of a hygiene factor. You have to have PMP, and PGMP will give you extra wings. And you know, especially when you go for jobs or interviews or promotion within organization, what will differentiate you from other people because you have PGMP, you have learned the standard of better way of doing the work, and people can recognize that. People can see the value you're providing by using the terminology you learned from PMI. You can talk in terms of benefit, benefit management, benefit identification, sustainment, and many, many other terms you have learned, and you applied that and help you to get you are improving into your organization. So I'm very, very happy that happened to you. So yeah.
Yeah, and Dharam, we can say in a closing note that getting the PGMP certification is a challenge. And what you get in exchange is, on one side, you increase the value of your professional brand, because we like it or not, in today's job market, we are like a brand. And if your brand does not increase value, you are losing value, okay? And at the same time, you are getting a lot of new ideas, new concepts, new terminology, new approaches that you can almost immediately apply first in your language with your management, okay? So when you start talking about benefits management, when you start talking about the strategic value, this is something that everybody gets almost immediately, okay? And this makes you look better and better in your own organization. So again, I'm very happy of my choice a few years ago and having worked at this thanks to your great support.
Yeah. And Vincenzo, you have been saying PGMP is challenging, PGMP is a difficult exam. Yes, if you compare with PMP, it's a little more complex and difficult. But to me, the difficulty means simply because you're not prepared. I'm not telling or talking about you, but when people say this was a difficult exam, the easy exam, when people say easy exam, means you are prepared. You know everything about it. When you say difficult, means that you're not prepared. But if you have right mentor, right guide, and I can feel proud of saying that I can, when I am working with you or anybody, I will give you the what exactly you have to prepare. So you not only pass the exam, but enjoy the exam.
Yes, Dharam, and let me qualify the word difficult. It is difficult because the knowledge domain is very, very large. Okay. And in order to refresh your knowledge in the whole domain, you need to make an investment of time. Okay.
Yeah.
But I can tell you that when I did the right things done to your help, I passed the exam first time with very high marks. So again, it's difficult in the sense that you need to invest time and do it right. It's not difficult because it's impossible.
Yeah, it is. It is a difficult exam. I'm not undermining the difficulty, but I'm saying if you put the required amount of time and you have the right guide and you have the books, whatever you have to, and you've done the job, prepared yourself in the most difficult environment, and you go to exam, you say, oh, this was easy. I don't know why Dharam was saying this was a difficult exam.
And this is what happened to me. In fact, I was worried not to pass because I was too fast. So this is true. I can confirm.
Yeah. So, I mean, guys, if you have any question, clarification about PGMP and even eligibility or how to pass the exam, and I mean, you can always reach out to me. I have a link. You can book an appointment with me at www.dharamsingh.co, which is probably mentioned here. And also, Vincenzo is also available. He is in Italy, and you can connect with him on via LinkedIn. He'll be more than happy to help you out. And collectively, we both can help you. He's a PGMP. I'm PGMP since 2010. So yeah, there are a lot of knowledge available. And I hope you continue to learn from these sessions as well, and continue to contact us and communicate with us. We'll be more than happy to give you back and help you as much as we can. So guys, thank you very much. Thank you, Vincenzo, for your interesting story about how it has helped you. And I'm sure a lot of people have already inspired. They wanted to take a next step, and you are a role model. Great. Thank you very much.
Adam.
Thank
Bye
you.
bye.
Bye.